Adobe Photoshop is dead. After watching this video, you will also have this feeling, what I am feeling, that is really Photoshop is dead. Because if you want to remove the background from the image, if you want to colorize the picture, if you want to grayscale the picture, I mean, it's just about adding a prompt and you will have your result, which will literally shock you. So before proceeding to the tutorial and before showing you how you can use this free AI tool, which can do a ton of image editing without learning you how to use that tool, it's just you will type it in and you will have the results appearing up on your screen with just giving instruction by the text. Let me show you the results of this awesome and stunning AI tool, which will give you this cool results on the images. So this is the image, which is a grayscale image, right? And just imagine how long it's gonna take you to colorize this picture. Can you even do that in Photoshop? I don't think you can. But this AI tool can do that really easily. So I took this picture and I created two results. That's the first one. And that's the second one. So let me compare these images with you. Take a look at that. That's the original one. That's the second result. And that's the first result. Could you do that in just a second? This AI tool can do that. Let me show you some more cool results. So I'm gonna close that. And these all images are free pixel images. I just Googled the free stock photos and found these images, and I thought to play with this AI tool, right? So this is an image where you can see she's standing alone. But what if you wanted to add in some more persons to the background? Could you do that with Photoshop? I don't think so. And the quality is stunning. So that's the result. And that's the original picture. Take a look at these photos side by side. Can you tell that these two persons behind the background are really AI generated? I don't see any difference. The fingers, the everything, it's look completely normal. And it's really hard to believe that you can generate these kind of images unlimited, free of cost, with the free AI tool. Awesome, right? Let's check out some more results. So you see this picture, right? How long it's gonna take you to remove the background from this picture? And notice this part here, where the leg isn't properly visible. You will have to recreate this part as well if you want to completely remove the background. Now let me show you the result of the AI tool. So that's the original picture, and that's the result. Now you can add in your own background, whatever you want to add in, really easily, right? We have any tool you can use. It's awesome. Let's check out the other result for the background removal. So that's the original picture. And after removing the background, that's how it looks. So it removed the background, it removed all of this part. Let's check out some more results. So you can see this picture of two women holding bags. What if you want to remove one female from this photo? I don't think you can do that from Photoshop, but this AI tool can do that. Take a look at the result. So I'm just gonna go to this folder, and this is the original picture. And this is the result. Unbelievable, right? Take a look at the other one as well. So that's the original picture. And after removing males from this picture, you can see we have this result. It's a little bit blurry on this one, but it still looks good. Right? So let's close this and check out one more result, which is, okay, we check the background removal, we check the remove person, we check the adding. Okay, yep. Now I'm gonna show you how you can use this tool completely for free. So in order to use that, all you have to do is just go to Google AI Studio. Yes, you heard it right. It's again Google AI Studio. So I already created one other video where you can simply live stream your screen and literally talk with the AI tool and learn how to use different tools. I'm going to link that in the description. I'm also add a thumbnail in this video so you can learn from that video as well. So if you want to learn any new tool, you can basically stream your screen and ask AI tool that where to click and how should I do that and how should I do that. It's basically going to communicate with you and teach you how to do everything. Now, we will click on Try Gemini and make sure you're logged in. Okay, I accept. Click on that. Perfect. Now, from model, click on that and click on Gemini 2.0 Flash Image Generation Experimental. Right? And now you can simply upload the images and get the results you want to have. Now, let's play around with it and go to pixels. I'm gonna search some photos and try to grayscale the picture. So let's remove these additional tabs. Okay, so let's first find the grayscale image and try to colorize it. So I'm gonna find any grayscale picture from the pixels. So let's try this one. I'm gonna download that picture. Perfect. Now let's go to Google AI Studio. Make sure this model is selected and then click on this plus sign, upload the image. And I'm going to upload the image which is downloaded. Here it is. Now simply say it, colorize this picture. And here we have the limit of 32,000 token count. And this image is just consuming 264 counts. So I'm going to click on this run or press command enter. Okay, check out the result. So it took 9.4 seconds to generate this result. Looks pretty realistic, right? Let's test out some other images if it works fine. So let's take out a little complex picture where we could have some different colors. Okay, this one seems a little more challenging. Let's try that out if it works. Click on free download. I'm gonna download this picture. And let's now upload it. Click on create prompt one more time so it can clear this and create a new prompt. And here we go. Click on this plus, then click on upload image, and then let's upload that image. So I'm gonna say one more time, colorize this picture. Okay, you can see the result. It looks awesome. So let's open that in a new tab. Okay, so that's the colorized picture and that's our original one. So that's the original one and that's the colorized picture. The result is simply awesome, right? Now let's try removing objects or persons from the picture. Now, kids playing or playing, let's search for that. Okay, so let's take this picture and try removing one of the person. Click free download. Okay, it's downloaded. I'm gonna again click on create prompt and then upload this picture. I'm just gonna say remove first kid from the left. So this kid on the left should be removed. Let's see if it works. It didn't work. Let's try again. Probability of unsafe content. That's weird. Let's try manipulating it. Remove first child from the left. Let's see if it works. Okay, I think there are some safety settings which you can turn on and off. Let's try one more time with a new prompt. So I'm gonna upload that image again. Okay, here it is. Remove first kid from the left. Nope, it isn't working for some unsafe content flag. I don't know why it is showing that. We are not doing any unsafe thing here. Let's try with another picture. Okay, let's download this picture and try removing the dad from here. Click on free download. I am going to again click on create prompt, click on plus sign, upload image. Remove male person from this picture, from this photo. Okay, let's see what's the result. I hope it doesn't say that it's unsafe. Okay, it removed, but it removed both of the child and the dad from this photo. That wasn't supposed to be done. Okay, let's try one more time. So this time I'm gonna say keep the child. Remove the adult from this photo. Let's see if it works. Nope, it isn't working. So there is definitely some issues, or you can say quality issues in the tool, but overall this is an awesome image editing tool through which you can done a lot of stuff like removing or colorizing the picture or making the even photo to grayscale. There are a lot of use case which you can do. It will automatically connect with your Google Drive as well. So if you click on enable autosave, it's going to connect it with the Google Drive. If I give it the permission, it's going to connect with the Google Drive and you will have your chat history showing up here if you enable that, and you can revisit your prompt which you have added the prompt. So that's one more feature. And one other thing which you can do is you can basically summarize the videos and get content out of it as well. So if I go to my YouTube channel and take out any video link, let's suppose, YouTube WebSense Pro. So that's my channel. I'm gonna click on that. And if I go to any of the video, let's take this one, which is for the SEO. So if you are looking to your SEO of your Shopify store, you can watch this video. I'm going to copy the link of this video and let's paste the video here and say, please summarize this video and create a tweet for me to post, and create maybe LinkedIn post, create a LinkedIn post for me Okay, let's hit enter and see what it says. So you can see we have 1 million token count available, and it's just consuming 500,000 token, and it's a big video. It is about 30 minutes long video, which it will summarize, and it will also give me the LinkedIn post which I can add to my LinkedIn profile, and let's see how long it's gonna take. Okay guys, you can see that we got the video summary. Here's the summary of the video and the LinkedIn post. The video discussed the difference between running paid ad campaign and search engine optimization. Explain why paid ads like result fast. Once the spending ceases, so do the result. Organic SEO, on the other hand, offer long-term benefit. So that's what I said and what I tried to explain, that if you are using SEO, it's gonna have a long-lasting effect. As compared to running paid ads, the paid ads gonna give you result, but for the really short period of time, the amount, the time you stop spending on the paid ad, it's gonna stop it. Okay, so that's what I explained, and now you can see that it also created that LinkedIn post for me. That's awesome, right? And it took about a minute, 62.8 seconds in total, to watch the whole 30 minute long video and create a summarized version of that video, and create me a LinkedIn post for that. Imagine how long a human would take to watch the whole video, summarizing the video and creating a LinkedIn post for your video. Awesome, right? So that's it for the video, guys. I think that's enough for this video. I have created this separate playlist for AI related tools, so make sure to subscribe this channel and turn on the notification bell if you want to keep updated for the latest AI tool which is going to be coming up. I'm going to be creating more videos related to AI. So make sure to keep watching. Until next video, have a great day.